All right, what's good, Simps? The Worst Duelist here. This is actually some two-week-old footage that I forgot I had. It's Metal Foes versus Shadals featuring Dollhouse YGO. I'll put the link in the description to his channel. So we opened a hand of five low scales, which is rather unfortunate, but you know, we'll make something happen. But I'm kind of raging about it here. So we'll scale the silvered, scale the Melcaster, and then Melcaster effect pop the silvered. We're going to go get the Parametal Foes Fusion. He's just going to quickly read this here. He's never really played against this deck. Well, at least since like 2015 or something. Normal Summon Gold Driver, we're going to fuse them away. We're going to make Mithrilium here because, you know, with a hand of five low scales, your options are quite limited. So we're going to scale Silver, pop Melcaster, and we're going to find the quick play, I think. Then we're going to get counter. And then we're going to Melcaster, add back the Gold Driver. And we're gonna scale our second Melcaster, and now we're gonna get the quick play because that's like the only line. Unfortunately, my spell and trap zone is pretty much just cut off this whole video. So, rip. There's not really a ton I could have done about that other than been more aware of it, I suppose. But so we're gonna end on this. It basically just sucks. I'm not really too sure what happened to. I bounce a Melcaster. And then he's going to set a monster and set free for his turn. He's going to pass it back over to me. So we're quickly reading the Zort list, making sure it pops cards, not just face-up cards. And then we're going to go ahead and fuse those two guys, and we're going to summon the Zort list. We'll be floating with the Thrillium on a 2-1 Chainlink 1 being Zort list. And we're going to pop the one closest to the deck, which is a Resh at all fusion, but it looks like a blank. So we'll draw for turn. It's Darkworm, I think. Yeah, it must have been Darkworm. Had to have been Darkworm. So anyway, we're going to normal Darkworm and activate the effect. He's going to go ahead and strike. We're going to activate the counter on resolution because he destroyed a card in my field. And then we're going to go get probably the Vanisher out of the deck because that's like the best target. Alright, so we got the Vanisher. We're going to banish any card in the field, which is quite nice to be completely honest. And we're going to banish the set monster. He's going to strike again, which totally sucks, but not really much I can do to play around that. I mean, you can play around one, sure, but I mean, I guess they always have the second. Anyhow, looks like we're just going to have to punch into the set monster as much as we would have liked to try to avoid it, but that's pretty unfortunate. So we swing in. Flips, it's Squamata. He's going to pop the Zort list, which is actually going to go to my scale because Pendulum Fusions exist for some fucking god-awful reason. So, you know, that going in the scale actually completes our scales, but there's no point. You can't Pendulum back the Vanisher. I think that's the only thing over there. No, I think there's Silvers over there. I don't know. I'm not too sure why I did it. I think I was just trying to be conservative because if it kills the Melcaster, I get another card back, which is nice. But yeah, so he's going to go, you know, do a run around here with Resh to get to a Hedgehog flip so he can get to the L, and then we're going to go for the App Clone with Aerial and Dragon, which is going to banish all of my things here. No, it's not Dragon. I actually don't know. I can't tell. I can't tell which one it is, but it doesn't matter. He's going to App Clone negate the scale permanently. Then we're going to go for Punch, I think. Yeah, he's going to punch over the Melcaster, getting me back the Vanisher, and he's going to go for Link 2, which is going to be probably the Anaconda. Yeah, he's going to go for the Anaconda. And then he's going to go for App Clone. Probably going to do Wendy so he can get another monster on board. Just for, you know, more advantage. Looks like it's actually going to be Squamata, though. Maybe Squamata into Wendy. I feel like that would make the most sense. Or maybe into Core to get back his L. But yeah, no, it's going to be into Wendy, so he can get the Beast. Yeah, there we go. For the draw two, which is nice because he's only on one card here. So next turn, he's going to want to try to make a push and win the game. So he's going to go for Anaconda, and he's going to send the spicy one of tech, the Magicalized Fusion, which is going to go for probably a window. Yeah, he's going to go for a window. No reason why he would go for second that clone. Yeah, he's going to try to stun me out and you know, kind of win from there with the Beast flip. So we draw here, it's the Stealing, it seems. We're just gonna reveal the Vanisher, and we're gonna banish the window. He's gonna scoop the because, yeah, that's enough damage. Probably, yeah, no, it's definitely enough damage over the Anaconda. Opening the driver, yeehaw. He opens set two, so that seems pretty good for me, seeing as how we have Abductor in the starting hand. We're going to scale the Volflame. We get one counter. We're going to probably scale another guy. Yeah, scale the Goldrive. We're going to get two counters. And then we're going to pop the Volflame with the Goldrive to find combo. And then he's quickly making sure that this does what he thinks it does. And then we're going to scale a Bismagear, get the third counter. He's going to Gamma, which sucks. He draws Gamma, I draw Driver. Must be nice. So we're going to pop the Goldrive. We're going to get a second combo. Just quickly flashing it to him there. And then we had the Souls anyway, but he has a Strike, so we're kind of fucked. And we're sending the Dissolver for cost. So yeah, that pretty much sucks. We kind of had to just pass here. Banishes the Psyframes and goes for a Sinister, sending Squamata and sending Wendy for Beast. Yeah, so he can just make a really big push this turn and try to make the game pretty much unwinnable for me. So that kind of sucks, but yeah, so he's going to, he's on two cards, it looks like. Yeah, I'm going to cut, he's going to draw. Flip the Beast because, yep, digging is winning. Thinking of the discard here, it's going to be Rilliona, it looks like. And he's going to normal the other Rilliona. He's going to go find probably the Magician's Invocation. He's going to get the Magistus Theurgy. I don't know how to say it, but it's basically just Monster Reborn for Magistus monsters, which is really cool. I forgot he played this. This was so that you can normal really, and then you can search this if you already have a fusion spell, and you can go Artemis and then make Cross Sheep after you use the spell card. So you revive the really and make the Cross Sheep, and then you can play from there, which is really cool. Definitely a neat tech there. And then he's going to choose his chain order. Oh, wait, no, I think he's trying to choose his chain order, but he already used Beast, so he's not going to actually resolve it. I end up telling him he needs to quit smoking so much. So he sends a Squamata, it looks like. Yeah, he probably is, because he's still digging. It's just, man, the glare was really bad in this video, unfortunately. We didn't even have the overhead lights on either. But anyway, he's going to Squamata for Court, looks like, to get back his L, so he can try to stay up on cards. Which is pretty smart, of course, in the game of Yu-Gi-Oh! So he's going to play the Magistus Reborn. He's going to get back his Rilliona. And then it's probably going to be Cross Sheep. Make the most sense. Yeah, we see Lake 2 for Cross Sheep. Yeah, makes sense. And he's going to add back Core, which is, surprisingly really good, because he can just keep that and the fusion in rotation if he wants to. And we're going to see set three. So I'm pretty much just fucked here. What's cool is I can pop the combos and search. Potentially, at least that's, the plan. So, yeah. We're going to Summoner's Art. That's going to be Ashed, which, I guess. Flip combination. Chain, Schism. Schism effect on activation. He's doing it all. Yeah, doing it immediately. What am I talking about? So anyway, he's going to make a Construct, it looks like. He's going to go Construct effect. Cross Sheet, so 2-1, and then he's probably just gonna send Dragon, would make sense. Yeah, Dragon, pop Abysmagear, and pretty much fucked here, because Driver's the last card in my hand. So yeah, we just scoop it up. So we go to the all-important game 3, I'm on the play, which is cool, and we're gonna try to make a big board, hopefully. We drew the counter, so that's a bad start. So we're gonna normal summon the Abductor. We're gonna get an extra counter for some reason. Scale with Bismagear, of course, and so we're just going to actually pop the Abductor with the Bismagear, and we're going to go find a combination. Scaling Melcaster, I think. Popping Bismagear. Explaining Bismagear, I guess. Setting combination. Oh, he gammed the Bismagear. That's right, you have to activate it whenever it's destroyed, and he gammed it. And so I am clear to Magician Souls. That was his fatal error in this game. This is where he ends up just losing, because he should have just gammed. He just should have waited. There's just no reason to gammed the Bismagear. I think he was under the impression that I was really relying on the Abductor. But after I popped it, he should have known that I wasn't. So I'm not sure. Yeah, definitely a big mistake on his end. So we're going to do the Souls motion here. We're going to send the two combos, draw two, and we're going to search two cards. So we just have like this massive grip of cards now. Looks like we're not going to scale that gold driver, or are we? Yeah, we're going to scale the gold driver. We're going to pop the Melcaster, get the Bismuth gear back, which is pretty much useless unless you have gate zero. But it's cool, you can pendulum summon it, and the souls, like subsequent souls, if you have access to the gate zero. So we're going to set the Parametal Foes, Volflame, and let's see. We already normal summoned. We're pendulum summoning. I was gonna say, so we're just normal summoning twice now. No, okay, so yeah, that was a pendulum summon. So we're gonna go into cross sheet and we're gonna fuse probably for the Mithrilium. Yeah, that actually has to be Mithrilium. Metal photo pendulum. So we're gonna choose, we're actually not choosing any chain orders, we're just using cross sheet. Yeah, we're gonna go get back our Magician Souls. I was checking Grave there to make sure I had enough spells for the Selene play, which you always should if you're comboing, because you'll have a fusion spell in Grave and the two scales. So anyway, we're gonna Selene, get back the Dissolver, and we're gonna use the Dissolver effect, and we're gonna use scale effect first. We're gonna get the quick play, and then we're probably gonna use Dissolver effect, yeah, and fuse with our scale for the Odd-Eyes Vortex Dragon. We're not going to bounce his Gamma, because that sounds like a bad idea. And then we're going to set an additional card from a hand, beat the counter, and we're going to tell him to go. So it's a pretty good board. You know, we got Gammoned, but it was on a Bismuth gear. I think opening the counter hurt, and also opening the Abductor on top of the Magician Souls kind of sucked too. But anyway, we're going to do the quick play spell, setting off the Bismuth gear, and the Mithrilium for Azortless popping the back row list of the deck, and we're going to use Mithrilium to get back our Bismuth gear. So this is a pretty easy line here. We're going to just go for an access code play, try to just go for game. So access code, and we're going to target the Selene so we can make him, 53, and then I'm telling him he can't actually activate the Imperm on activation, and then he asks if he can do it on res, and I'm like, oh yeah, you're good. So on res, he negates the access code, which kind of sucks. So we're going to Tribute for Jackal King, because we're pretty much godly. And then we're going to Dragon Shrine so we can get the two counters and negate his flip. And yeah, he just scoops it up. That's that. That is the game. So we won that one 2-1. And yeah, that's the video. Hope you enjoyed it. Like and sub if you haven't. I'll see you next time, Sips.